Foods that will make you live to be 100 years old or older, and a few foods that will shorten your lifespan. Check this out. This is important.
Dr. Paul Hader, Master Herbalist. Get healthy now.
Hi, Dr. Paul Hader, Master Herbalist here. Well, today I want to talk about foods that will help you to live to be 100 years old or older. And before I get into that, you know, if you like what I do, please give me a thumbs up. Please subscribe. Please tell others. Please watch those little ads at the beginning, because they really do make a difference of bringing a few cents towards my wife and I. I appreciate that greatly. Also, please get a copy of my new book, Live a Cancer-Free Life. If you Google Live a Cancer-Free Life, my book will come up and my name will come up. And you can find it on Amazon, eBay, and all kinds of different places. So allow yourself to partake of my book. You know, half of you and more actually are going to come down with cancer, and a large percent of you, are actually going to die. And we don't need that. Get a copy of my book. We can cut your chances of coming down with cancer, and you can be good for the rest of your life. Nobody needs to die of cancer. We can make a big difference in your life. So what do you eat to live to be 100 years old? You know, I'm going to be 68 here pretty soon, and I don't feel or look 68, that's for sure. I only have a few crow's feet in the corner of my eyes. Other than that, you know, I just got through doing part of 2,000 meters on a rowing machine, and I feel great. There's no doubt about it. I don't have any aches or pains or medications I take or anything, and I feel fantastic, and you can too. Well, one of the first things that is super, super, super important. You know, I looked at all the different blue zones around the world, but people live to be over 100. The Okinawa in Japan, Sardinia in Italy, Nicoya in Costa Rica, Ikara in Greece, and Loma Linda in California, and on and on and on. There's quite a few, actually. And one of the things that they all have in common is they all eat beans of some kind, whether it be soybeans in Okinawa, or there'd be chickpeas in Sardinia. Every single one of them eats at least a half cup of beans every day. You know, this happened to be organic Goya chickpeas here. Actually, just make sure you rinse them when you get that done. Open up that can and pour them out. Rinse them really well to get rid of the sodium. Or you can buy also some sodium-free ones, organic now. Unfortunately, I can't get those here, but hopefully Goya will start making those too. But we have a Goya factory here. But beans are great. They boost up your microbiome in your body, the good bacteria. 44% of your daily fiber needs is taking a half cup of those wonderful beans. Gas, you know, it's a good thing they give you gas. Actually, it's telling you that you're actually working your good bacteria and they're starting to grow. And actually, the more you eat beans, the less gas you have. Also, if you take a little bit of kombu, seaweed, and cook that with your beans, you won't have gas. Also, there's things like Beano out there that will really help to get rid of gas, and so you won't have gas with your beans. But beans are one of the most important things you can eat. Absolutely, positively. There's 40 different types of beans. Also, fava beans. Fava beans are amazing for boosting up serotonin and dopamine in the brain, and I highly recommend fava beans. There is not a bean I don't like. I'm a bean crazy person. I just ordered some and got some Greek gigante beans. They're about this big. And buttery on the inside. Boy, they're really great. Not cheap, but they're wonderful. I highly recommend them. So beans are also a good source of iron and magnesium and folate. Also, they keep your levels of energy up. And I was in California when my wife and I was there visiting my mom when she was alive. And, you know, California beans you don't find in the restaurant. So all of a sudden, I was dragging. And so he said, I'm going to the store, I'm going to get some beans, and I ate them in the car. And right away, I had energy and I was feeling good. Also, lots of magnesium in beans, good for your heart and bones and brain. Also, if you look up beans and long life, you'll see a ton of information. It's unfortunate that only 4% of Americans eat beans, and this is an inexpensive food. If you buy a pound of dry beans for like $1.26 to $1.50, that's multiple dinners right there, multiple lunches also. So really inexpensive, good food. I highly recommend it. It will do your body good. Also, greens. You know, the Okinawans eat a lot of greens. They eat a lot of dandelions, which they mix with spinach and eat them that way, either cooked or raw, and especially good. They love dark greens. There's no doubt about it. I recommend kale, arugula, spinach, beet greens, Swiss chard, lettuce, all the leafy greens. There happen to be some mixed greens here. Don't these look beautiful? I just want to eat them right now. Actually, our little dogs love greens now, you know, and actually it's made a huge difference. And now one little black dog's tummy, she used to have tummy aches on a regular basis, and she started eating this, and she's become a lettuce freak, actually, to tell you the truth, and her stomach aches disappeared. So I highly recommend it, even for dogs. So they love it now. I was really surprised, because she's kind of a finicky eater, but she loves them. There's no doubt about it. Also, sweet potatoes, especially the Japanese sweet potatoes, will make you live longer. There's no doubt about it. Lots of good agents in Japanese sweet potatoes and sweet potatoes in general, but there is a particular agent in Japanese sweet potatoes and it'll make you look younger and keep you young in general. And you can buy those on eBay. Lots of whole grains, not processed in any way. You know, this morning we had rolled oats with lots of fruit, and we had four different types of fruit with it, and I'll get into fruit here in a minute. I recommend organic buckwheat, organic quinoa, organic brown rice, red rice, and black rice, sorghum, millet, amaranth, teff. Like I said, oatmeal, great for the heart. Even Dr. Esseltine talks about that. Also, corn in moderation, organic corn, fonio, F-O-N-I-O, and Job's tears, and also some seeds in general, too, are really good. Also, the bran is really good for breaking down all the starch into very slowly so you don't get a spike in your glucose. Also, fiber helps to keep your digestion in check and also lower your cholesterol. Also, it's very good for preventing blood clots and triggering heart attacks and that type of thing. Also, it's really good because it has a lot of magnesium, selenium, copper, all kinds of things, and wonderful grains, whole grains. Also, there's studies showing that actual whole grains lower down inflammation, infections, also cardiac problems, and also cancer, helps with rheumatoid arthritis, gout, asthma, Crohn's disease, ulcerative colitis, all kinds of neurodegenerative diseases, all kinds of things. Next thing I highly recommend is good veggies, all kinds of good veggies, lots of antioxidants, and they help you to live a long, long life. Especially cruciferous veggies, like, you know, wonderful Brussels sprouts and cabbage and wonderful cauliflower and things like that. Really good broccoli also. Those are really help to keep away cancer in general. Also, fruit. Fruit is very important. New studies came out showing that eating fruit, especially berries, every day helps to prevent Alzheimer's and dementia. So I'm telling you, it is really good for the body. I eat a ton of fruit. Maybe that's why I have a wonderful complexion as I do. Also, non-starchy roots. This is not including potatoes and yucca and root and things like that. I recommend like red beets and carrots and parsnips and rutabagas and turnips, all kinds of non-starchy roots. Those are non-starchy roots, especially red beets. You know, having three or four cooked or raw red beets a week are really good for building up nitrous oxide in your body, more athletic performance, and you just feel good in general. There's a few foods that I highly recommend that you avoid. Puffed grains. That removes all the vitamins in general in the actual grain itself. You get all the vitamins, minerals, and everything when you have a whole grain that you just cooked slightly, which is great. A little bit of nuts is okay, but lots of nuts. Even Dr. Esseltine did a study with lots of nuts, giving up 500 people, 2 ounce package of nuts over 5 years, and found they all at the end who ended up with cardiovascular disease. So not good, lots of saturated fat. Avocados, you know, one a week is fine, lots of fat, and that's not good. You want to stay away from too much fat. Also, stay away from added oils. Oils actually just surround each cell and go into each cell and prevent insulin and other hormones from being able to get in and do their work. So one of the first things I do to reverse diabetes is take people off of oils, and that's really, really important. I'd see their blood sugar drop by 30 points just like that. It's just amazing. Also, stay away from chips. Oh, man, not good. Also, crackers, you know, all kinds of refined grains. Those are killers. There's no doubt about that. So try to stay away from other things. Any type of also things like veggie cheese, not good. Make your own cheese type of sauce that you can put on it. Yeah, you can use a few nuts to make that cheese type of sauce. Also, you can use nutritional yeast for that. Also, stay away from protein powders. It'll kill your kidneys, that's for sure. Also, stay away from white rice and non-dairy ice cream, all kinds of things. Any of this processed stuff, not good. Also, soda. Two sodas a week will kill your kidneys and you'll end up with kidney disease. I can promise you that. Also, stay away from ice cream and candy. And chocolate is a, you know, fattening monster. A little bit of the chocolate or cacao powder, really good. That's good. No fat. You can use that for making brownies and things. Stay away from animal products. You know, the beef, the lamb, the chicken, the seafood, the fish. All these, you know, the dairy products, the kefir, the yogurt, all these things, the eggs. All these have 12 different toxins in them. And we know that they start cancer and inflammation, which starts disease. And I haven't had any of these animal products for, you know, like 15 years now. So, and I feel fantastic. Also, stay away from fast food, processed food in general, and also stay away from GMOs. Yeah, a lot of people showing the studies show that they cause cancer. There's no doubt about that. So try to stay away from all of that. Eat a wholesome, whole foods, plant-based diet. And if you want to make a difference in your life, you want to change. I just saw a lady who was on TV. She weighed 245, and in a very short time, she lost 120 pounds. And just really amazing. And she became a vegan like me, and she feels fantastic. So it can be done. You can do that. You can feel fantastic. Give me a call at 831-869-9119. Let's get rid of your chronic diseases. I guarantee you, whatever you have in the way of a chronic disease, we can make it happen and make it go away. Call me at 831-869-9119. Have a great day. Remember a couple things. You know, remember life is supposed to be lived in a simple way. Take every moment as it comes and have gratitude. You know, breathe in love and breathe out gratitude for every moment that you have. And also remember, I love you, and remember God.